baby kicking. 7 facts you need to know. Your baby has been moving long before that, but the sensation is unfamiliar, and you might not recognize it for what it is. A baby's movements aren't very strong in the earlier stages of pregnancy. Some mothers think they just have wind. If the placenta is at the front, anterior of your uterus, it may buffer the feeling of your baby's kicks for some time. Women having their second or subsequent baby usually recognize the flutters of their baby's movement much earlier, even as early as 12 weeks. Number 2. Why do babies kick? Babies tend to move mostly in response to what's happening in their environment. Too much noise, light, or even certain strong foods can stimulate your baby into kicking and moving. Babies also need to stretch and move for relaxation. If you're moving about, it can be soothing for your baby. They'll often relax and even go to sleep. Mothers-to-be who participate in relaxation exercises such as meditation or yoga may find their babies are quieter. This study found that pregnant women undertaking a guided imagery relaxation exercise experienced a reduction in fetal movements. The exercise resulted in a physiological signs of relaxation in the mother, such as lowered heart rate, respiration rate, and skin conductance. This, in turn, lowered fetal heart rates and decreased movement of babies. Number 3. How many baby kicks is normal? The average number of kicks falls between 15 to 20 per day, remembering this includes all movement, not just kicking your bladder. Every baby is different, and this includes their movements. Some babies literally sleep all day and move at night when you're asleep, whereas others seem to be moving all the time. Babies rest and sleep in the womb as much as 17 hours a day, usually for periods around 40 to 50 minutes at a time. If you've been busy and on the move, you might not notice your baby's wakeful movements. Most pregnant women will notice a peak in activity after mealtimes, after being active and during the evening. Number 4. When should I count kicks? There isn't a normal pattern for movements, but you've probably worked out what is normal for your baby. As your baby grows and develops, you shouldn't feel less movement. Rather, your baby has less room to move and the sensation of her kicks will feel different. Sometimes it might feel like your baby's movements have decreased. It's important to contact your care provider immediately if you notice the following. Experiencing less than 10 movements in a 2-hour period, reduced or no movement in response to external stimuli like loud noises, patting or prodding your belly, or the sound of you or your partner's voice. A gradual decrease in your baby's movements for more than 2 consecutive days. Reduced movements can mean your baby isn't getting enough oxygen or nutrients. Your care provider can monitor your baby and check their well-being. Number 5. How to check baby movements? It's easy to miss feeling your baby kicking, especially if you've been busy and active. If you think your baby's movements have been reduced, always contact your care provider for advice. Most commonly, women are advised to lie down on their left side, support your belly with a cushion, for 2 hours. You should feel at least 10 separate movements in that time. If you don't notice movements in a 2-hour period, you should contact your care provider immediately. It's important to have your baby's well-being monitored sooner rather than later. Number 6. Does reduced baby movements mean something is wrong? While it doesn't always mean something is wrong, reduced movement can be an indicator of fetal distress from lack of nutrition or oxygen. A maternal and fetal assessment will be done to look at the cause of reduced fetal movements. This involves an ultrasound to check blood flow of the placenta and baby's well-being, as well as how they respond to stimuli. Sometimes a problem is detected, and your care provider will discuss with you how to proceed if your baby needs to be born early to prevent further complications. Number 7. Will my baby move less after 36 weeks? Your baby should always be moving throughout the day. After 36 weeks of pregnancy, babies have much less room for big movements like kicks and rolls. This doesn't mean you should feel a reduction in movement. They'll still use their hands to explore their face and body, play with the umbilical cord, and try to stretch in their cramped surroundings. Regular and rhythmic movements will indicate your baby has hiccups, and some babies have hiccups at the same time every day.